Bam! Mr. Taru, in this video, we're going to be taking a look at three points in three-dimensional space. We're going to find the component form of vector AB and vector AC, and then, hence or otherwise, we're going to find the area of the triangle of ABC. Now, you can have basically three ways of finding the area of this triangle defined by these three vertices. We can use the SAS formula, the fact that the area is equal to 1/2 the magnitude of side A times the magnitude of side B times the sine of C, the angle between those, in this case, would be vectors, AB and AC. You can find the magnitude, the distance basically, between the points of AB, BC, and AC, and use Heron's formula. We are going to use the vector formula for finding the area of a parallelogram and just simply cut that in half. Okay, in the description below, you're going to find a video to where I sort of talk about more of the geometry and explain where the formula comes from for finding the area of a triangle, or hence a parallelogram using vectors, but we're just going to apply that formula in this video. As opposed to introducing it like I did in the other video first. Find the vector AB. Okay, so we have an initial point and a terminal point, and so to find that vector in component form, we work with the terminal point of the vector first, so we have the coordinates of 0, 4, and 1. Movement along the x, y, and z axis. We're going to subtract that with the components, or the x, y, and z components, of the initial point. So we have 0 minus negative 3, 4 minus 1, and 1 minus 2, giving us a vector of 3, 3, and negative 1. And this is how my book that I'm currently teaching out of writes vectors in component form in a stacked format. You might see some arrow brackets and these components moving horizontally. You could also write this as 3i plus 3j minus 1k. If you're doing sort of like that full written form using the component vectors I, j, and k in your notation. Vector AC, again, initial point of A, terminal point of C. We'll start with the terminal point, 1, negative 2, and 5. Minusing with the coordinates of our initial point, negative 3, 1, and 2. So we're looking at vector AC has the components of 4, negative 3, and 3. Just before I go on, make sure I didn't make some silly copy error. Now, the area of the triangle defined by these three vertices, working with vectors. Okay, well, so the area of a parallelogram, that is going to be equal to the magnitude of the cross product between vector A and B, just giving you that as a formula. Well, a triangle is simply half of a parallelogram. So the formula that we're going to use for this triangle is that the area is equal to 1/2 the magnitude of the cross product of vector AB and AC. So we are going to find that cross product, that vector. Remember, cross product gives you a vector which is perpendicular to the two vectors that you use to find that cross product with. So cross product of AB and AC, we're going to take basically the derivative, determinant, we're going to set up a component row, I, j, and k, and then make a row with the components from vector A and C. Okay, and I talk about in the video, I have a link in the description, that the cross product is not commutative. If you reverse this order, you get an opposite answer. But we're going to be ultimately working with the magnitude, which is length, so that's not an issue for us here. We're going to be looking for the determinant of the 2x2 matrix, taking out the row and column that has this component vector I in it, and we're looking at 3, negative 3, negative 1, and 3, and that's going to create a coefficient for the component vector moving in the direction of the x-axis, minus, so we have a plus, minus, and then determinant, take out the column and row that has the component vector in the direction of the y-axis, so 3, 4, negative 1, 3. Add that with the determinant. I'm just writing this in here as really make sure that you realize that that's what I'm looking for. Take out the column and row with the component vector in the direction of the z-axis. Now we're looking at 9 minus 3, so 3 times 3 is 9, and then minus the product of negative 3 and negative 1. That's going to be a coefficient of vector I. Minus, we've got 9 minus negative 4. And the determinant of this 2x2 matrix, which should have a little vector k over here, we're looking at negative 9 minus 12. Vector k. So our cross product is equal to 6i minus 13j plus negative 21 vector k. Or the cross product is equal to 6 negative 13 and negative 21. And I got to this point after I made this problem up and realized my numbers are a little bit gross. This was really intended to make to be a non-calculator question, but yeah, that didn't work out. And that's okay. Let's grab our calculators. We worked through this. Now, simply the area triangle is 1/2 the magnitude of this vector. So the area of triangle ABC is going to be equal to 1/2. To find the magnitude of a vector in 3-space, of course, we know we just square each of these components and add them up, basically just the distance formula with one extra dimension in it. So we're looking at the square root of 6 squared is 36, 13 squared is 169, and negative 21 squared is 441. And now we're looking at 1/2 the square root of 400, 500, 560, 600, 630, 636, 637, 646. Now, grab your calculator if need be, and that is going to come out to be approximately 12.71 square units. And that is how you find, component form of vectors in 3-space, and a quick review introduction of how to find the area of a triangle using vectors, which are defining two of the three sides of that triangle. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.